Welcome back to the Talos Principle. Let's go do some yellow puzzles. There's two yellow ones and two red ones. Big lump of mine. Well, I'm gonna be a lump on the ground if I touch any of these things. Okay, so they're basically kind of randomly moving throughout, and I just need to get through? There's also a force field, though. So I've got two boxes with which to do this, huh? I think I might be able to jump up here with one box. Oh yeah, easy. You know, I want to see if I can jump on top of these things. I'm going to wait for this thing to come back, and I'm going to jump right on top of it. Come on. Okay, so it instantly explodes. Gotcha. Makes sense. Trying to see if I could, like, stand on some rocks or something. Wow, these rocks have weird collision. Look at this. They're pushing me. Rejected. Yeah. Look at me vibrate. Alright, looks like I can get a little bit of elevation going into this corner, but not enough to jump on a stack of two boxes, so I don't think I'm gonna glitch salute this one. That's not a word. Well, I mean, it is a word, but not in the way I used it, but it sounds cool. Solution? Glitch salute? Yeah. That one just stays there. Wait, what? I had no idea that was possible. Those things can balance stuff on their head, my god. I was just curious what would happen if I dumped it on top of it. I thought it would just, you know, fall, tumble off from the top of it and just tumble onto the ground, but no. Oh my god. Well, I can certainly jump out of the... Well, I can't really jump out of the world because you can already run out of the world, but I could jump on the wall, which in this case would be completely pointless. Alright, let's just hold on a second here. I probably shouldn't have put two boxes here. Yeah, I probably should have been carrying one box in my hands. Because now I need one of the boxes for here. Wait, I need the other box too. I need both boxes over here. I think at this point I need to kill myself. Suicide! How can I possibly take the box off of it? If I approach it, Oh, I need to do it from here. That's what that other platform's for. Yeah, I can take it off from above. Okay, so which one reaches over to that? That one? That one. So I've got to put my boxes on that one. Is that the one I was taking before? No. Okay. I need to swap boxes, I think. This is a really cool puzzle. There we go. Okay. Does that change any old puzzles I visited? Would that allow me to do anything that I didn't think of to do before? I mean, I guess you have to be above them to put them on top, though. Because I don't think you can get close enough to put them on top without blowing up. So I'm trying to think if there's any situations where I had both boxes and the mines and some sort of place to elevate myself. I mean, there is that weird place I was just at, the one with only three puzzles and the one red room and there's like no secrets, as far as I can tell. That did have mines, but it didn't have any boxes in there. It just had, jammers. Connectors. Bouncing side by side. Alright, they like to use the mines, it seems. The power of the mine. Duh. What is with the collision on these rocks? Blue power, two things to open with blue power, give me access to a second connector. What am I doing? I should probably connect it to actual blue power. Let me guess, this one will never quite open. No, it's gonna open. Oh, no, it doesn't. That was so close, though. Look at that. It's like 1% away from completing. Ooh. There's a star just right there. Alright. Red power. I guess that's probably not coming from within here. It's gotta come from somewhere else. Well, you know what? Maybe there's red power at the top of this one. At the top of this pyramid. Nope. Maybe it's on some other tip. Maybe it comes from the sun. Ah, whatever. Figure that out when we need to. Well, I just need to throw these things. I just need to delay one of these, right? How do I do that without killing myself? Bouncing side by side. There we go. Oh, what? It didn't even get to me. Balls. Exploding balls. Damn, that was easy. Okay, so where could I get red power? If I got red power from another puzzle room, and it was coming in through the entrance, which means it would have to come from over there. If it was coming from over there, I would need a connector here. And then I could place a connector. Alright, I need three connectors. Because I need one there in the entrance, one here, and then one in here. If it comes from the door. But maybe I could do the same thing I did in the last place, which is... Well, actually, no, that was two places ago, wasn't it? Put a connector on top. Seems likely. Okay, now I've unlocked the ability to get the yellow flashing thing in the top left of my screen, whatever that is. I still think it looks like a skateboard, but I think it's actually supposed to be one of those little, like, broken pillar platforms that we saw the AIs moving about in that one kind of strange Easter egg area, full of other AIs just like me. Because I saw them using all the tools that I think I've gotten so far. Using fans and boxes and connectors and whatnot, and the recorder. But I also saw them picking up these pillars and then placing them down, and I think that's what that is. Alright, well, let's not do the one that has no tools, supposedly. Let's do the one that requires a ton of tools. Fans and boxes and connectors. A fan across forever. This one is long. Okay, so the end goal is to get red power over there. And looks like you have to go all the way around to do that. Red power here, something with blue power over there, then you go around and come around there, and more red power. So what's the point of this? Can lift something up in the fan. Alright, I probably need that connector, and that probably... Yeah, that requires blue power. Okay. Probably gonna have to lift some connector thing up above there and on the fan. And to start all of this, I only have one jammer. If the box is inside where the red piece is, that implies that it's not needed to get the sigil. And since I was just talking about how I think I need to put a connector up on something to provide power to get the star, I think that box is for doing just that. I think that box is for that star. Okay, you can actually jam fans. I don't know if I've ever done that before. It doesn't really matter at the moment, but... It doesn't raise you up much. Where does this take me? Oh, hello. Ah, whoa. Holy crap. There's two boxes. This thing is multi-staged. Oh my god, there's three boxes. Yeah, there's no way I can't get up on the freaking walls using three boxes. It's like guaranteed wall fun. Alright. If I'm up in the fan, can I get... Yeah, I can get red power, so... I think I need to do that and bring those objects back. So I think I need to get red power over here and then bring those objects to the main room. Yeah. So, to do that, I would need... two connectors and a box. I have one connector. Wait. No, I don't. I have a jammer. I don't need to use red power to get in there. It's just one of the ways I can activate it. I can just do this. I can just go jam it. Yeah. These things are very misleading. They always make me think, this can use red power, therefore it needs red power. No. It can use red power, but it doesn't need red power to open. Okay, got some tools. Connector, jammer, and a box. Just do this and see what happens, I suppose. Guess I'll go grab the other box while I'm here. Yoink. So this opens with red power as well. I don't have another connector, so I guess I should probably just use the jammer. I just want to see where this goes exactly. Can I reach that from the other puzzle room? Maybe. It's not super high, but maybe. And can I reach that from here? No. Could I reach right through there? That's cutting it. I don't think I could. Because the connector is actually lower than the point of my head. So where I'm aiming is actually above where a connector would aim. Although I could put it on a box in the corner, I suppose, but I don't think so. Alright, let's leave that for now.
Let me out.
Would this be enough to jump up on two boxes? Would it matter? Two boxes could get me over there, but... Okay, so I need either red power, or to get the jammer over here. Most likely the jammer, because I don't think I have enough connectors to possibly go around all this stuff. Stupid sun, get out of my eyes.
Stupid sun.
Could I access the red power from this corner? If it was floating on the fan. Over the fence. Would it be over the fence? I think it would be. But the problem is I don't actually have two connectors, so... Let's see if we can get this one. So I need blue power. Or a jammer. One or the other. And to do that, I should jam this from the inside. I'm gonna need to take my tools with me. Let's grab all my shit. Could even take the fan blade, but there's literally no point. Okay. Well, this doesn't really help, does it? I still need red power to... I need red power to open this, to take the jammer in there to get that. No, it does help, never mind. Because I can just do that. Okay. Okay, so we have all our stuff except the box right at the very end. Which we can't get until we actually get to the end, so forget that. So now we can make this happen by going back to the way it was before. There's probably a lot of ways to do this. And with so many boxes, I'm sure you can just jump up on the wall somewhere. So let's set this up the way it was before, with this in the air. Now we don't need that. Don't think I need that box. And then... I guess I'll use this box to hold down the button. So I guess we do need the box. Come with me. Oh yeah, easy. God damn that sun, go away! There, hide behind a pillar. And now we have an extra box. We have three boxes. You know, normally I would... I feel like I should just wait on trying to break this level and come back to it when I've actually finished every level normally, but this took a lot of setup. And if I come back here later, everything's probably going to be reset. So I actually think I want to do it now. First, before doing anything else, let me see if that red power is high enough to just simply use it to get the star. Okay, it does go over the walls, barely. Let's see if there's an angle. Alright, please stop. Oh wait, but I have to reset anyway. I have to reset to get the other connector. Shit. Don't I? Oh, no, I don't. No, yeah, I do, because if I take this off... Ugh. So I would have to reset if I wanted to do this. Okay. Well, let me just see if it's even possible. Let's see, is there even an angle? Look at it teasing over there. So, not quite, I can just see the top of the red, but if I put that connector on a stack of two boxes, which I could easily do, then yes, it would be over. So I think that's what I need to do, I think I need to put it on two boxes, and then I could access it. But yeah, let's do that later, because I do have to reset this puzzle if I want the other connector, which means it would reset this one, and I'd have to do it all over again. So let's worry about that stuff later. Okay, last red one, the one with no tools. Bullshit. Did I read this? Yeah, I did. That's the few come this far thing. Computer's over there, yep. There's the pooter. Okay. Is it here that the crowbar is? Nah, I think it's like there or something. Whole lot of jamming. I see. Yep, none of these take any power. Just jamming. Okay, where are my tools? Epitaph, child program, blah blah blah, codename Samsara. Terminated here. Logic. Program elected to reset. Final memory dump. It is clear I cannot bend the world to my will. Faced with eternal torment, I see that overcoming these challenges will not free me from them. True freedom must come with detachment from the struggles for answers. I wonder if every time I'm resetting, I'm doing something horrible to myself. And every time I die and it, like, resets me, is that... Am I leaving my own? Final memory dump in my own progeny program? Am I creating a new version of myself every time I die, supposedly? I guess. See, there's a tool. But how do I get to you? Oh, I go through the open place where you just walk right through because there's no walls and then you grab it. Okay. That is a reasonable way to attain objects. This does not help. This does not help. This also does not help. Alright, so my final goal is to get here. Actually, wait a minute. This might help. Yeah, let's let them out? Actually, no, they're just gonna hit the sides, aren't they? Yeah, they do. Okay, I need to desync these so I can run past them. And then go through. Except I don't have the keys. Alright, getting a little bit ahead of myself, I guess. Give me the keys. Wait, how do I get the keys? Oh. And go! I can unlock... I could jam this and then... Well, I can't get through the other one. I need to get these two jammers together, because when you have them together, then you can use them to, like, leapfrog through force fields. You know, jam it from one side and then jam it from the other and then grab the other connector and bring it in with you. I think that's what I need. Shit, I think I already fucked up. How am I gonna get this out of here? This thing is already starting to come back, isn't it? I need to unjam it and then run forwards. Ah, fuck. I could jam this and... No, I'm still dead. How do you get in here? There's another jammer. Yeah, I need to get the jammer out of there, though. I need to get these jammers together. I can't... What can I do here? I can't... This ain't gonna work. Alright. Maybe if you're fast enough? I don't even remember where the jammer was. Nah, here it is. Okay, do I have enough time to go run and get it? One, two, three. Okay, I have about 3 seconds to go get it and bring it back.
Oh.
Okay, we're good. Yeah, so it requires 2 connectors for that, which I can do, because again, I can get these together, and then... Yeah, we can do a lot when we have these together, actually. In fact, don't I have everything I need to go get the... Oh no, we have to deal with the turrets, don't we? Because I can get into the room. That has the red piece, but I think there's some turrets I have to contend with. So yeah, now I can leapfrog. And let me guess. I can't leapfrog here because if I stand indoors, they're gonna shoot me? Yep. Do I have enough time to stand in there and do it? I don't know, but let's play it safe. Let's just go get the other connector. The other jammer. After doing that, I don't want to risk anything. It's a little bit tight on the timings here. Get these inside. Awesome. Yoink. And, yeah, that should be it. In fact, I don't even know what the point of that place is. Why would you need to use that? I mean, I could have done that instead of going through the mine alley, which would have been safer. But maybe more time- whoa! Maybe more time-consuming? Actually, no, it wouldn't have been safer, because I would have had to contend with that. Although I could have done the leapfrog thing with that as well. I don't know, I guess you can just take either way, really. I think I like the one I just took more, though. I guess I might go out that way, though? Sure, why not? Let's change things up. Let's go out a different way. If I jam a thing 3 times, does it explode?
Triple jam.
Okay, we're good. Yeah, in this place they make getting on the walls kind of pointless. Kind of. You can still use it to get objects outside of these puzzle rooms, but it's useless in the sense of it doesn't allow you to go out of bounds. Well, kind of. I mean, I guess it allows you out of bounds of the puzzle room taking the, you know, puzzle pieces with you. The jammers and whatnot, but not in the same way it was before. Well, there's no boxes, so I guess I'm probably not getting up on the walls in this one. No boxes, no fans. I do believe it's time to start breaking this level. So I know where both the stars are, that's a good thing. There's one in that puzzle room that needs red power, and then there's one over here, which... What does this one need again? I know it has a fan. Does it require power? Or I think it's a button. Isn't it a button? Let's go check. I'm pretty sure it's just a button. Yeah, it is. I remember now. So I could just take anything. Literally, if I can take any tool outside of a puzzle room, I can just take it over here and... There you go. In fact, I could even use the fan blades themselves to keep it on.
No way, that doesn't work.
Okay, well, this shouldn't be too hard, really. I'm gonna have to reset and kind of redo some puzzles, but, yeah, I can make this work. So, I'm gonna go do that, and I'll be right back. Okay, well, got a party going on here. Three boxes, one jammer, and one connector. In fact, you know what, just to be really, really, really sure, I could even just get this going on a stack of three boxes, just to ensure that it's high enough over the wall. Looks a little bit tricky, though. It pops up for a tiny second. Alright, one more try. No. One more real try. Don't mash, click. Ah, forget it. Two will be enough. Okay, cool. And then now that I've reset, the other puzzle room is blissfully allows me to get both connectors. Ooh, look at that. It's actually not quite high enough. Yeah, the connector over the wall is actually still gray. Yeah, I mean, it's just barely visible, and I can see it with my eyes, but the connector is lower to the ground. There's nowhere on the ground where I could put it. No, okay, so I do actually need all boxes. All three boxes. And there's probably another way to do that. Like, you probably can just get up on the walls or something and put the connector there, but... In fact, maybe we should just do that. Yeah, screw it. How would I do that? Okay, jumping on here is easy. I need the connector in my hands. That pushes me off. I can't jump on here like this, can I? Well, yeah, I could if I had this box up here. Okay, so yeah, let's try this. Oh no, don't mess it up. Oh. If you come into the fan under the boxes, that messes everything up. Okay. There's something I can jump on. Ooh. I saw it. There we go. Is this actually any higher, though? I don't know if it is. Oh. You gotta be careful with the... Let me just put this down. You gotta be careful with these fence things, because the collision for them is bumpy. Like, it's almost like you're sliding on ice when you're on them. So you can't stay on them. Okay. Where would be the opportune place to put this? Don't really know. It's hard to tell. I think here might actually be okay. Well, I need red power. Here? Yeah, there we go. Cool. And that's actually going to allow me to get the other star, too. Because now that I got on the wall, I can just take one of those things out of bounds, which means I can hold down the button and then do the fan, and yeah. So let's go do that. I wonder if I can use the crowbar to hold down the button. If there's anything else on here. Oh, shit. So this doesn't allow me to get anywhere interesting, but there could be something actually up here. What the hell? Collision on those things is really weird. Keeps pushing me off.
Rejected.
Yeah. Some weird, like, rounded collision going on. So is there anything else up here? Nothing obvious, but it could be something really small. I mean, that floppy disk was awfully small. Alright, let's go do this. And then I might come back there and jump around a bit. I did Google the crowbar, by the way. The CRO bar, and I didn't find anything. I have no idea what it's referring to. It's gotta be some sort of a reference. Whee! That was an extremely slow fan ride. Nice and gentle. I like it. I should leave a message up here. Whoa. That scared me. I don't remember where the paint is, though. Okay, so I found all the stars here, but I didn't find any Easter eggs, unless you count finding the crowbar itself as an Easter egg, but I feel like I should be able to do something with it. I'm gonna look around a bit and see if I can find anything extra. And I just found something very special. Okay, so I got the crowbar, which came from that pile of rocks right there. And then I just kept running in this direction. Guess what I found? Something that has been covered. And what is a crowbar useful for? For making dinner, of course. I mean, for prying. Ooh. Ooh. Oh, whoa. Can I go further in this direction? Nope, that's the limit. Okay. This is most likely an Easter egg. It's very dark. So many cubes. What was that sound? I hear a kitten. Okay, let's take a look at the different cubes. Very pixely. I have no idea what that's from, though. That's obviously from Serious Sam, one of the Serious Sams. That's the lovely companion cube, of course. That's the cube from this game. What the hell is that? It's like a little air duct. And that is a Minecraft cube. I don't know what that is. It's fragile. And it may be where the meowing is coming from? It's got like a real... That's a real shipping label. DHL is a real delivery company. I think the meowing's coming from here. If that's a real shipping label, could you actually read, like, the addresses and the barcodes and stuff? And figure out where that was sent to? Hmm. I'm surprised they'd leave, apparently, real delivery information on there. And I don't know what the hell that's for. Pour that. Is there nothing more I can do it? Oh, wait, break. Is there actually glass here? It's probably hard for you to tell, and it's really hard for me to tell, but it looks like there's no glass here. There is no glass there. There's glass here. You can see the reflection. But there's no glass here. And there's... Oh, yeah! It's actually been broken. Glass is sometimes really hard to tell whether it exists or not. Okay. It's a cat! Come back here, kitty! Where'd you go? I scared it away. It's really, really hard to tell where there's glass and where there isn't. Whoa. Ugh. I can't actually go in there. And I can't crouch. Okay, can I break any more? No? Okay. I think that's it. Maybe one day I'll get to see the cat again. Maybe one day I'll get to hold it in my arms. Because I don't know if you remember, but there's some promotional material for this game that shows someone who looks like me, you know, shows these androids, and it shows a kitten in its arms. I don't know if there's a specific purpose for that, but I don't know, maybe one day I get to hold a cat in my arms. Perhaps that's the proof that I'm human. I like kittens. The final test. Will you pet the cat, or will you... Well, I mean, what? What else would you do with a cat? That's most likely all that's here, but I'm going to take a little bit more of a look around. Okay, I think I just found something else. I was just running out here, and this tree has a sign on it. And it says, don't look up.
The colors on my screen have shifted.
What in the hell even is that? It's a weird-ass fruit. I don't know what that is. Can I do it again? Can I get more fruits? Aww. Okay, well, I'm just messing around on these walls up here. And I don't see any, like, floppy disks or anything like that up on the walls, but I did find something interesting that I might be able to get to. And that's that. If you notice, there's like a little hollowed out place in there. What's in there? I wonder. And what's the best way to get there? Because I might... I might be able to make this jump, actually. Maybe. It's probably gonna take a couple tries, but let's try this first. This seems the safest. Here we go. Here we go. Hello? Cool! I found a prison! And I imprisoned myself. Okay. I think I found everything this world has to offer. I found both stars and two different, Easter eggs. That's most likely it.
The land of tombs is yours now. And let this be a lesson that only through faith may death be conquered.
That is not at all what I learned. So, that is the last officially normally accessible puzzle room in this place, but there's something worth noting here. Each hub, at least Hub A and Hub B, which is this is Hub B, has its own star room, and each star room seems to take 10 stars to get into. Now, in Hub Room A, if you got every single... Was it every single star? If you get every single star, you have 10? I think it was. Wasn't that the case, that if you got every single star in Hub A, you had 10 stars? Or was I one short? Maybe you know what? Wait, I was one short, wasn't I? I think I was actually short. Well, regardless, whether I was one short before or not, I'm certainly many short here. So I only found 7 stars, I need 3 more. The only other star that I've already visited that I know I can get at some point is the one in the main hub place. Back here. I'm just looking around here to see if there's anything up there. So I know the place up here has a star. The one that requires blue power. The blue power that's guarded behind wood. Yes, there's a star back there. So that's one more star I can get, but that only gets me up to 8. Now, if this trend continues, if I go into Block C, and that requires 10 stars to get into its star room, and it doesn't provide me with 10 stars, that obviously raises the question of, where are these phantom stars? Like, there's stars missing. There's not enough stars in this system to get every star room. that I've seen. Unless the stars are maybe hidden behind the wood that I need the axe to get into. So there's... I definitely don't have every star in these areas. I'm missing stars, I'm pretty sure. Unless there's extra stars to compensate in Block C, but I doubt that. It's probably behind the wood. That's what I'm thinking. Whoa. Some weird rendering going on there. Look at that. On the stairs. I have no idea what's going on there. Look at that. Anyway, it's probably some weird, like, bump mapping, normal mapping kind of thing. Anyway, I think I made excellent progress that episode. Actually, I made really good progress. In one episode, I solved 4 puzzles. 2 of them yellow, 2 of them red. And I got 2 stars, and I found 2 Easter eggs. That is damn good. Okay. Well, I hope you have enjoyed so far. And when I return, I guess I'll move on to... Hub C.